In his communication while starting off today's parliament session, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayebwa, expressed concern over the recent upsurge in DNA testing, saying it has mostly affected children who are found victims.
I think we need to guide the nation. Right, Honourable Prime Minister, you need to come out, you guide the nation. Because what is going on, you know, innocent children are falling victims. No, you don't know what your parents were doing, you don't know what happened. All of a sudden, you see someone saying, stop using my name. Someone is saying, bring back your national ID.
Tayebwa asked the Prime Minister Robina Nabanja to guide the nation on how DNA should be conducted without breaking families and ruining the lives of innocent children. He emphasized the sensitivity of the matter and urged government not to look on but at least provide counseling services to victims.
We'll see how best we can counsel these people. Maybe there are regulations around it, but we just don't need it. And also ask men who are out there. By the time you go, make a test for around 16 people.
The Deputy Speaker also called on government to ensure that DNA laboratory centers are regulated to avoid the issuance of fake results that might rub salt into the already existing wound.
I don't know whether some of you are foreign victims. You know, that's an issue which you swallow our own quietly. So some of you might be seated on it. But you have cancer as in parliament. If you have in such a challenge, such a problem, please.
MPs joined the Deputy Speaker and urged the Ministry of Health to put a halt on COVID-19 testing and carry out a review of all DNA testing labs across the country. Legislators gave their opinion on the escalating demand for DNA testing, as some proposed that it should be mandatory on birth.
Can we add the DNA test to that restricted list so that it is only done on a court order or to solve the problem? We want to save the mental health of our children and of the men who are now committing suicide. It's not adding value to the economy.
Why is it that now men, us, including me, are complaining when we're looking after the children?
You should know that you are not even sure whether you belong to that very clan where you are now. So, Right Honourable Speaker, remember we held a conference in this country.
I wouldn't want in the unlikely event to have a test that will not match me with my children. It would be a great disappointment.
But if it is a matter of every person walking to the clinic to test, at the end of the day, we are going to get very many families which will break down. And the end result will be the suffering of children.
Government has assured Parliament that they are going to carry out an assessment of the laboratories to ascertain if they are accredited for that purpose.
And an assessment is being carried out to check are these laboratories accredited, are the clinics accredited? Because it could be possible that people are running to clinics and labs which are not accredited by the Minister of Health.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.